What's going on, everybody? I'm Tim from Lone Tree Milsim. Today we're going to be talking about my gear loadout. Typically when I play, I like to run as simple as possible. You don't see me with a whole lot of bells and whistles. I basically bring nothing I don't need and everything that I do. All right, so starting off with my headgear. I don't typically wear a helmet, so this is what I got. Just a basic Condor ball cap in our team colors. Nothing fancy about that. For iPro, this is the goggle system off of a JT Flex 8 Woodland Camo paintball mask. I've had this for years for both paintball and airsoft. I've loved it. It gives me total vision all the way around. It never fogs up except if it's really, really cold outside and I'm sweating like a dog. Attached to it, I've got the basic Bravo mesh mask, which I cut down. It was a lot of basically mesh, just taking up a lot of space on the lower half. I didn't like it. I cut it down. I put it in the oven for about 20 minutes at 220 degrees. That melted the hot glue. Holding this banding on, so I pulled it off and then reapplied some hot glue on here. So when I put it on, it doesn't get in the way of me shouldering anything. The nice thing about this, the band stays on my head. It's got silicone on the inside. This thing never falls off, never really moves around. I absolutely love it. And I've mounted it. I just took some Velcro zip ties, like the kind that you take your guitar power cords and tie up with. That's just what I mounted it through some of the holes in the paintball mask. Really like that. For comms gear, typically I'm a radio man if we're playing on a larger game. This isn't anything fancy. This is just a basic Z-Tac boom microphone from Evike. Nothing fancy. It's not the greatest thing in the world, but it gets the job done for the amount of Milsim that we do. I did remove the top band just so it would get out of the way, and I haven't had any problems with it. All right, time to talk about the chest rig. What I'm running right now is a DEFCON MPS style chest rig by Echo One. I really like this thing. It's very lightweight. It's not as tough as stuff like King Arms or anything like that, but it's right around there with Condor. It's 600 denier nylon, which seems to be doing the job so far. I've got mags straight across the front. I find it's very easy to just pull them out whenever I need them. Even the ones way over here are fairly easy to get to, although I don't normally go for those right away. Those are over here. Pistol mags, I like to keep them over here. It's very natural to go for my pistol here and reload here. That's just how I've always played. Mat pouch in here. I run my radio in here. I used to run a lot of designated pouches. Now I just find it's a lot easier to have the slimmest load possible so nothing gets in the way. That's why you don't see me with a ton of gear on right now. I just like to be able to move a lot and not carry anything I don't need. Z-Tac push to talk right here. I really like this thing. It's very easy to get to. It hasn't broken yet. I've had it for a while. I run my hydration over my right shoulder. This vest did not come with pads. I just added those from one of my old vests. They seem to work pretty well. On the back, I've just got a basic hydration pouch. This piece of Velcro right here, I typically throw patches on it, but in the event of a long game, I'll just throw an extra EMT pouch on there if I need to carry extra water, magazines, ammo, snacks, whatever. Back here, I've got my dump pouch. I find it really easy just to throw a mag back there, throw items I pick up in the game or whatever. That's basically it. I don't have a whole lot of frills to this thing. All right, so for my primary, I'm running a KWA KM4 RIS. I really like this thing because it's extremely reliable. I've had it jam on me twice since I've had it in about 5 years. It's fairly accurate.
It shoots right around 400 feet per second, even after having it for a year. It's stock, it comes with a 120 spring. Again, nothing crazy. I don't run a lot of optics or accessories just because I'm all about just getting that BB down range and nothing really else. If you want more details, there is a review on it. Look in our description and we've got a link for you. For my secondary, I'm running a Elite Force 1911 TAC. Again, nothing pretty, it just gets the job done. I squeeze the trigger, a BB goes down range. Magazines, there's one. Magazines run about 15 rounds. Again, nothing crazy, but in the cold weather, CO2 works really well, it always shoots.
Travis is down. Good kill!